Hi, Dan again. This is the Xotic XJ Pro Bass from Xotic in California. And I've just been zooming around, having a bit of a noodle, getting used to its sound, and just seeing what I can tease out of it without really messing with any of the settings. Let's get in, have a look at the details, and of course, more information in the written review, so don't forget to read that as well. You heard the bass in the little intro connected into the Gensler Magellan 350 combo with the array cabinet, and that's mic'd up so you can hear what this sounds like when plugged into an amp. Okay, so of course it's a 5-string, it's a jazz style bass. Let's get up to the headstock and we'll do the details. 5 tuning keys. And these are Hipshot, I believe they're the licensed tuning keys. Flip that over. Love the headstock shape on this. Okay, there we go. Beautiful maple neck with this lovely, lovely satin finish all the way down. Let's come on and have a look at the back of the body whilst we are here. Nice and slim neck, bolt-on body. Okay, and this body is an ash body. So the bass feels a little bit substantial, probably for kind of people with a smaller build or back problems like me, might want to test this instrument out before you go and do a 2 or 3 hour gig with it. But even so, beautiful piece of ash, really lovely sunburst finish. 2 batteries, 18 volt circuit, electronics in here. Compartment for the controls, should you ever need to go in there. Flipping the bass back over, we'll have a look at this lovely deep cutaway on the body as well, like so. You can see that lovely finish, it's gorgeous. Onto the fretboard, maple fretboard, really lovely finish to it. No fret edges and beautifully finished fretwork. Looks really lovely. And I'm a sucker for nice, simple black dots on maple. I just think it looks lovely. Really nice. Coming down, 12th fret marker, there's double dots. Dots on the side, double dots for 12th fret as we come up. And it's a really slim neck. It doesn't feel massively wide. So it's quite comfortable even for smaller hands. Onto the body. Lovely kind of like red tortoise shell pick guard. Xotic's own pickups here, but let's just take a moment to have a look at these. I've always had a bit of a weird bugbear, I suppose, with pickups in general. I mean, usually they're like black pieces of plastic and I can't really get massively excited about them. But this is nice. We have got a wooden cover, which appears to be kind of ramp-shaped, but with a lovely little thumb rest up here. So if you're a player who wants to actually lean on the pickup, and you've got a nice little area there to put your finger on. Unlike a good old P bass, which we know the little kind of sticky outy bit, which the screw goes through, it kind of like digs into your finger, and we're so used to it, we don't even think about it these days. But it's nice that this is a nice little place to put your thumb. And there's one here as well on the bridge pickup. So wooden covers, which I think look really, really nice. I wonder what they might look like if they were in maple to match the fretboard. Or certainly with a rosewood fretboard model, I think that'd look very, very good with matching covers that way. And then coming around here, we've got the active electronics. So here we've got a 3-band active EQ. And do you know what I really like about this? Is I'm not the kind of person who sits there and fiddles with the EQ all the time. So I like that these are small controls. Kind of out of the way. So we've got treble, middle and bass, cut and boost. And then coming across to the big controls here, we've got a master volume, a pan control between the two pickups, and then a master passive tone control. This is quite a nice addition because if I pull up the volume control, the EQ is bypassed and I've got a straight vintage style passive bass with that passive tone control. But I have the added facility of being able to switch on the EQ and have the characteristics that that can bring me, like extra bottom end, or I want to might scoop out the mid-range to make it more pingy with my slap bass, for example. So that's a really nice touch. We should hear that. So as usual, what I'll do is I'm going to put the bass into passive mode. We're going to have a listen to the two pickups mixed, and then we're going to play with the EQ. Okay, so here we go. This is just the front pickup. And I'm going to noodle around. Let's see what this sounds like. Straight on to the bridge pickup on its own. Good, little bit of B string there as well, so you can hear what that's doing in passive mode. And then a mix between the two. This is your typical jazz bass setting. Here we go. So here we go, let's punch in the active EQ and we'll have a little listen to that. Here we go. That's more like it, a bit more of that lovely richness. I like a modern jazz bass sound. So incidentally, I've got the bass boost, kind of like pushed quite hard actually. Mids cutaway and a little bit of treble boost as well. Let's flatten that out and we're gonna have a little listen to what it sounds like with a milder setting. So a little bit of bass boost, a little bit of treble boost, and just a little bit of cut. That's just what's going on with that. And both pickups on at the same time. Yeah, slowly dials back to a kind of more warmer vintage kind of tone, I think. I sort of like want to lean towards that brighter sort of sound, if I'm honest. But let's go the other way. Let's boost the mids. And I'm going to leave the bass where it is. I'm just going to pull back the treble control a little bit. And I want to want to get a bit of warmth in there. Maybe I'm going to dial back towards the bridge pickup a little bit as well for that sort of 60-40 kind of thing. Here we go. Let's see what this sounds like. Okay, it all got a bit crazy there for a moment. And I added a bit of B string action in there as well. And I think the boost in the mids really helped that B string. It sounded a bit more authoritative. So I like that a lot. I do like that. Okay, something went crazy there. I really liked that sort of bridge pickup leanings in the tones, and my notes seemed to be a lot smoother, and I felt I could be a bit more confident with moving around this instrument, which I've not really played before, so it felt quite comfortable doing that. So hopefully you can hear there's a lot of different sounds available from this bass, and I didn't really spend a massive amount of time exploring them. That's something that you'll definitely want to do. Okay, so rounding up, we talked about the chrome hardware on board, and that's just like a fairly nicely balanced instrument considering you've got so much chrome hardware on the headstock. You know, it doesn't seem to want to neck dive too much, so I'm pretty confident that you're going to be comfortable with this instrument, even though it is heavier than some, you know, mainly down to the ash body, I suppose. Okay, so rounding up, I can see that you get a nice gig bag with this bass as well. It's a nice padded one, so you're going to be on your shoulder, off to a gig, no problem at all. And finally, I also know that these basses are assembled in Indonesia, but they go back to Xotic in California to be finished off and have all the kind of like finer details. So you get that lovely finish from Xotic basses. Hopefully a bit of a cost saving over some of the premium instruments. But that's not to say that this is not a premium instrument. This one feels really, really good. Okay, details going in the written review. Please check that out in the magazine. And I look forward to doing some more playing with the Xotic bass. Great, thanks for checking this out, and I'll see you again soon.